wherein searches are now underway at Videocon and NU renewable offices in Mumbai. In fact, FIR has been filed against Venugopal Dhoot and Deepak Kochar. No FIR yet confirmed with regards to Chanda Kochar. She's just under the scanner yet for giving loans to Videocon.
Well, obviously, if the CBI has thought it necessary to move forward and file an FIR, it means that preliminary investigation shows that there has been some wrongdoing as far as the managing director of ICICI Bank was concerned, along with the Videocon founder members. So this is something which we will have to wait and watch what evidence has been collected by the CBI, and when the interrogation starts, when the investigation starts, what emerges from that. So this is only the first step, and I think a lot of skeletons may come out of the closet in the coming months, and that's what we may affect the prospects of the bank itself.
Mr. Anina, this is Vijay Iyer here. Sir, from the legal perspective now, how do you see the new board with new chairman and the management would try to go from here on? Because A, now we know that FIR has been filed by CBI. On the same hand, we also know SEBI started the investigations on the whole issue of conflict of interest in corporate governance on ICICI Bank. So, and also the Sri Krishna, one member led by Justice Sri Krishna, are expected to submit his report perhaps in the next 10 days or so. So, looking at the current situation, what is that the ICICI management needs to do to protect the institution? Because clearly, this legacy or this controversies are here to stay for a while now.
Well, the new management needs to come out clean with whatever information they have, number one. Number two, they have to learn the lessons from the past to make sure that these things are not repeated by any future manager, however senior he may be. And number three, that whatever loss has been suffered by ICICI Bank should somehow be recouped for the benefit of the shareholders and investors. So the new board has a very, very long way to go, and they'll have to put the act together to make the institution much stronger than it is today.
You're coming to me, right? Mr. Anina, if I could continue and ask you a bit, ICICI board somewhere still is yet to grapple or understand the fact, why are they stopping shy of filing and consent and settling the case with SEBI? It's been so long that ICICI reconstituted board also has not taken the step. Clearly something more than that meets to the eye, and the board is unable to take that decision. Why can't they go for a consent and settle the case?
Well, I can't answer that question because I don't know what is the facts, but obviously the management will, I think they should be well advised that in case there is any wrongdoing, then they should compound the offense and settle the case. But obviously they will go by what their legal advisors tell them based on the facts appearing. So it's very difficult for us to speculate as to why they have not gone for compounding so far.
Right. And Mr. Anina, earlier, you know, in terms of where the CBI was concerned, they had indicated that they were studying the documents to verify whether to convert the preliminary inquiry into an FIR.